Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1705. Wrap every formula in a new formula. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday, I was over in Perrysburg, Ohio, doing a seminar, and Tory, right at the end of the seminar, asked a question that was very interesting. Tory has a whole bunch of different formulas, right? And she wants to select the range and wrap a new function around all of these formulas. Like, for example, maybe we want to add equal round after the equal sign and then comma zero at the end. Well, that's a tough thing to do. You know, I initially said, well, maybe what we could do is we could do find and replace and change every occurrence of the equal sign to a, for example, caret equal sign. That will make it not be a formula anymore. So now that they're not formulas, then we can kind of do things in a couple of steps. So we can take the equal sign and change it to equal round, open parentheses, replace all, and then hope that there's only one parenthesis in the formula. Boy, that's just a dangerous thing right there. And then replace all. And then finally, once all that's done, we can change the caret equals back to an equals and replace all. Click OK, close. We'll get out of show formulas mode. And now everything, all of the formulas here have a round around them. But that wouldn't work if there was any other right parenthesis in the range. Like even these formulas up here, the rand formulas, if we change the right parenthesis to right comma zero, that formula just, it goes bad. So maybe the way to go, I'm going to switch over to VBA, Alt F11, selected here and did insert module, and then a tiny little macro, add round for each cell in selection. Old formula is equal to cell.formula. New formula is equal to, we start out with the literal equal round, open parentheses, and then the mid of the old formula starting with 2. Now, mid in VBA is a lot like mid in Excel, but we just have to say, we don't have to specify a length. We can just say it starts at 2, and if you don't specify how long, it goes all the way to the end. Why do I start at 2? That's because I want to get rid of the opening equal sign, and then at the end, wrap it in comma 0. Comma 0. Cell formula is equal to new formula. So let's come back here. I'm going to select the whole range, Alt F8, and then run the macro, and it adds the round function around the whole thing. And this could, in theory, be work. You know, could do other things. For example, Alt F11. So we want to have the old formula, and then maybe wrap everything in the proper function. Although that doesn't make a lot of sense today. Maybe we need to proper everything. And so just click run, and see now we've added the proper to all of these. Of course, then our other formulas go bad just because I changed the numbers to text. But you could use this method with a little bit of VBA to add just about any kind of wrapper function around all of the formulas in a range. It's certainly an interesting question. If you're watching this on YouTube and you have a better idea of how to do this, please feel free to leave us a comment. You know, as I said, it was Tori's question right at the end of the seminar. I'm like, oh, I'll have to think about that on the way, on the drive home from Toledo back to Akron. So, a couple of different methods there. I'm not sure I like either one. Probably would take that second macro and develop it into a nice little add-in along with error handling and so on. But yeah, that's what we have today. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Tory for asking that question. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.